Cheers, mate. It's me or them.
Elysium's moss-covered chambers, carved of stone, stand untold numbers of eternal monuments in tribute to the greatest heroes which mortality.
The place is near as gloomy as the house.
What is that on your wrist there, stranger? Let me see, is that a bracer of the Myrmidons?
Wait, this? How did you know? It's just a keepsake from a friend.
A keepsake? From a friend? You tell your friend, then, that Patroclus waits for him, and that he holds no grudge should he return to him.
Checking up on you, sir.
Now go.
Shields.
Fun. fists are hungry to fight. Couldn't have said it better myself.
How fares your war against the dead? The boatman Caron ought to invest into a boat of more substantial size if he's to keep up with my work, my kin.
Hits the spot.
More drawn as he is, much like the unassuming moth onto the flame of righteousness.
Oh no, not the flame of righteousness. Are you finished? Let's get this started. I've come a long way.
Hear that, Asterius? Our fiendish visitor is begging us for mercy, begging us, no doubt, to drop our guard. Together now, my friend, let's vanquish him, and may the glory of Olympus guide us.
Thank you.
To open it. I'll take the service exit, thanks.
Tread lightly, boy.
Thanks for the tip. Take this one. Long way from home. Check. Floor. Stone's urns have coin in them, don't they?
At last, the willful prince has ventured all the way up to the surface of the mortal realm. Yet still he is encased within the earth itself. The gateway to the underworld. A threshold from which there is no escape.
We'll see about that. No, not this.
The multi-headed Cerberus stands vigilant before the underworld's entryway. The tales of what happens to those foolish enough to attempt to pass are far too graphic to describe.
So it's really come to this, boy. After everything we've been through. Well then, this is how it has to be. There's nothing left to say. Except for on your guard. No, but seriously, boy. I know why you're here. There has to be a way to make you look the other way. What if I help you with the Sator problem? Would you let me go? Please. I have to find Persephone. My mother. You know what this means to me.
After a moment's hesitation and deliberation, the voracious Hound of Hell barks once, affirmatively, toward the prince, who sets off in search of something that can sate the monster's appetites.
Good. Now I just need to head off the beaten path here and see what I can find. Lots on offer here. Maybe this way. You. Thank you. poisoned at the moment, thanks. What is this stuff? Hope this can get me out of here. Got to keep searching. Just what I need. Let's see here. I bet it's in here.
Ah!
Doesn't taste like anything. Data storage. Disgusting. Cerberus will love it. Perfect. Phew. Time to deliver the goods. Must be hungry, huh? Here's the fee. Boy, I got your favorite treat. But you have to promise to let me pass if I hand it over, okay?
Terrifying Cerberus accepts the fetid sack and scans the darkened hall for where best to consume the stomach-turning contents.
I owe you one, boy. Did it. Wow. Oh, of course.
I never grew accustomed to the air up here. It gusts senselessly whichever way it pleases. I suppose you must prefer it to the stillness of the air below.
You know, you're right. The air up here seems pretty good so far. But I will reserve judgment till I've had my fill. I have to say, though, Father, the Helm of Darkness suits you. I'm touched you dusted off on my account.
It should not have had to come to this. For all your antics with me yet around the house, I always kept my temper, have I not? Unlike you.
Well, let's see. You've berated me repeatedly and often. You've lied to me, mustered your wretched forces to kill me over and over, but sure, I'll grant you that you've always kept most of your anger bottled up. All that's about to change, then?
We're gods, boy. Killing one another is our lot. Although I always thought I was above it. I told you that you cannot leave this place. It seems I must enforce my rules myself. I'm sending you home. Now.
No, you're going home, not me.
I suppose that you must hate the very sight of me. You'll understand then why I wear the helm of darkness. Darkness. Child, I would expect such treatment from my brothers, but from you. Ugh. this. Behold. You shall look back on this and thank me, boy.
Ah, damn you, father.
Well, back to it.